talk about how to achieve the best treatment for anti-aging as well as cancer control. This will apply to anybody who already has cancer and is going through the Western medical treatment or who wants to prevent getting cancer. Now, we achieve the best diet through ketosis. Now, ketosis, a lot of people probably are not aware of it. Most of the doctors and medical students already know this concept. A form when the fat is metabolized in the body in the absence of high sugar or high insulin levels in the body. So they are water soluble and most cells in the body can use them, and even brain cells after some adaptation can learn to use them. And we call it ketosis when the blood levels of the ketones are above half millimoles per liter. And we can achieve this level of ketosis through the diet, and this is the best diet. Now, a lot of us have heard of ketoacidosis. This is a dangerous condition which happens to diabetics who are insulin dependent and who go without treatment for a while. And that's a fatal condition. But ketosis is entirely different. It's very beneficial to the health. And keto adaptation is when you maintain your body in a state of ketosis for a while and the body switches to use ketones as primary fuel source rather than sugar. Now, the first indication that ketosis helps our brains came from a study on children with heavy seizures. A while ago, when children were given medications to control seizures and were not able to get good results, doctors resorted to putting them on a diet of a lot of fat and very little carbohydrates to induce ketosis. And then we found out that these children could get full control of their seizure disorder. Not only that, then we got results of these kids after they have gone through regular aging and diet. We got results of their autopsies and none of them had cancer. So it was amazing that when most of other people of their age had cancer when they have done autopsies, we have to remember that a lot of people do get cancer, although it may not show up as a disease. We get cancer almost 100% of the time when you're really old. And for example, 80-year-old person has 80% chance of finding out that they have cancer in the prostate glands. If you're 85, it's almost 90% chance. But these children who had been on ketotic diet or ketosis diet did not get any cancer. And also, US Navy SEALs did seizure protection study, and they found out that ketone supplements prevent seizures, improve mental performance, improve physical performance, as well as they were able to dive and recover from dives better. And so, now, we talked about the children and about the autopsies before, and if these children could avoid getting cancer, it's obvious that even normal people who can maintain this kind of diet can avoid the cancer, and similarly, they can also avoid the aging process. In 1920s, we learned that tumor cells don't need oxygen to survive, but they needed glucose. So they use glucose and they burn it without oxygen to get the energy. So these are differences between the cancer cells and the normal cells. Normal cells on the left side, and the shape is regular, shape is irregular for the cancer cell, as you can see here. And so Normal cells have predictable division. They divide in a predictable way, but the cancer cells divide in an uncontrollable way. And also, cancer cells are seen by the immune system. And immune system protects normal cells, whereas cancer cells are not seen by the immune system. They are invisible. And normal cells will make blood vessels only when repair is needed, but cancer cells make blood vessels all the time. Normal cells love oxygen, and cancer cells hate oxygen. And normal cells stimulate repair and growth, and cancer cells kills and damages the cell. So normal cells use glucose, which enter through the transporter with the help of insulin, whereas cancer cells, they crave glucose, and the glucose enters cancer cells by slipping through the cell membrane without a need for a transporter or insulin. So cancer cells will not waste energy because they don't use oxygen, where they have low efficiency. And with normal cells, the pH is usually alkaline, but cancer causes acidity. And normal cells can either use ketones or glucose, but the cancer cells can only use glucose. They cannot use ketones. So normal cells can adapt to ketones when carbohydrates are restricted, and protect the cells from increased stress when they are using ketones. The cancer cells cannot use ketones. So if carbohydrates are restricted, usually cancer cells die. So this is how much your blood glucose rises on a diet of carbohydrate. It rises very quickly to high levels, but usually comes down within 2 hours. Protein, you get less of a high. With fat, we get the lowest rise of the blood glucose level. And also, people think that carbohydrate is the essential food item, but really what you need to live are these things: water, energy, minerals, amino acids, fatty acids, vitamins, miscellaneous. Carbohydrate is not absolutely necessary. You can live without carbohydrate. And next item is that sugar always causes inflammation. Glucose always causes the bodies to swell because it attracts water, and then you get inflammation, which leads to all these diseases. And for example, heart disease and strokes and cancer are the biggest killers of humans. In addition to that, it causes diabetes, obesity, immune diseases, muscle diseases, and nerve diseases. Carbohydrate addiction involves same thing as the other addictions, like drug addiction, for example. So when you eat carbohydrates, you get a burst of dopamine, and then it makes you feel good, so you start craving it. Then you have to eat more and more, and to get that same dopamine high. And before long, you are getting addicted to carbohydrates. And so you think you cannot live without it. So it's just like cocaine addiction or any other drug addiction. And another thing about our nerve cells or brain is that our nerve cells and axons and the dendrites, and these are insulated by fat. More fat we have, more protection we have for these nerve cells. So obviously, you have a low fat diet, you have a higher likelihood of getting Alzheimer's and other nerve degenerative diseases. And so usually your blood sugar is around 100, and you need to eat only 7 grams of sugar to cause that. That is caused by only 7 grams. There's only 7 grams of sugar in the entire blood volume at any given time. But for example, if you eat one slice of bread, it has 5 spoons of sugar. One serving of rice as many spoonfuls of sugar. So insulin is what causes fat storage in cells. If there is insulin, the fat cells will take up the glucose and convert that into fat storage. And on your diet, and this is the amount of fat the diet contains, the lowest amount of fat is found in a lot of the vegetables, and highest this is the carbohydrate content of the diet. The lowest amount of carbohydrate found in vegetables, things such as ripe olives, grapefruit, and small amount found in carrots, turnips, onions. Very large amounts are found in potatoes and baked beans, boiled rice, bananas, and so on. So the fats are butter, egg yolk, whipping cream, lard, olives, things like that are fats. Carbohydrates are mostly things like bread, rice, oats, corn, things like that. Proteins are their animal proteins, like chicken, turkey, egg whites, fish, or there's proteins from legumes such as beans, quinoa, and so on. So when you're going on a low carb, high fat diet, your body produces ketone, and we can easily test this with urine ketone test. You can find urine testing strips from the pharmacy, and you can test it. And when you go through this diet, initially you will use up the glucose which is found in the blood, and then you use the glycogen stored in liver or muscle cells. And then when that is depleted, your liver will start producing glucose, and after that, in the next phase, the only glucose comes from the production from the liver and the kidney, and the muscle and the fat start using ketone up to 100%. Initially starts taking up only 50%, but later starts taking 100%. Eventually, when you are in the ketosis phase, where you have gone through a few days of this diet, you get to the level where even your brain cells are 80% ketone filled, only 20% filled by sugar or glucose. So 2 to 4 weeks after you go on this diet, you get increased number of functioning mitochondria in the cells, and you start losing weight, and also your body starts repairing fast. You also get increased growth hormone production in the body. So this starts the process of anti-aging and weight loss, and also reverses certain disease processes, especially things like diabetes, high blood pressure, even cancer. Cancer cells cannot survive too long without high glucose. And if you're on cancer treatment, your cancer treatments will work much better on this diet. And gastric bypass is heard about. People hear that you can do gastric bypass and lose all your weight, but it is a very cruel procedure introduced by the medical industry, and people who do this suffer through their whole entire lifetime, and they usually die early with complications. And so I don't recommend that for anybody. And people are afraid to eat fat because in the past, people, especially the medical industry, used to say that saturated fat causes heart disease, but now we know it's a myth. In fact, one of the latest studies from 2012 found out that people who eat most of the fat had the least amount of heart disease. And we know that is because of low amount of carbohydrates these people eat, and that causes low amount of inflammation. And what we recommend for people is to start on a good diet, and you don't have to eat a lot of meat. In fact, you can achieve ketosis without eating any meat. So you eat raw vegetables first. You could eat three kinds of vegetables, such as cucumber, tomatoes, carrots, or bell peppers, three or four of these, and then you eat a vegetable soup with some added legumes such as garbanzo beans, dal, cowpea, so on. You could add a liberal amount of coconut oil or even butter with salt into this soup, and you can choose the amount you add depending on how hungry you are. You should not eat any fruits because they have sugar, and then you should weigh in. If you haven't lose weight, you will see it very soon. And you can even cut down on the legumes if you are gaining weight. Even legumes have some carbohydrate, you don't have to eat too much of it. But the fat you don't want to cut down. If you want to lose fat, you have to eat fat. And this would be the healthiest diet for human beings. And you can stay on this diet. And if you want to achieve even better results, to lose weight and pH or obtain better skin, you go with our natural medicine program, which consists of 9 antioxidants and vitamins. And also you can use our creams to obtain additional benefits, and you can call us and find out more information about that. Also remember, the best way to lose weight without getting loose skin is to try this diet, because when you are on ketosis diet, especially if you combine that with intermittent fasting, you get a high level of what we call autophagy. Your cells start eating what you don't need, so the excess skin will be eaten up by your own cells, and there won't be any excess skin in your bodies after you have lost even 100 kilograms. Thank you for listening to this lecture, and let us know if you need extra help.